Cody lost, Vince McMahon won, and we are barely talking about AEW. Kevin, how's your weekend been, man?
So what do you want to talk about?
Oh my God. First of all, I've watched more wrestling than I've probably watched in 10 years, all in the last 72 hours. It's hard to remember it all because I was watching two shows at a time. Mm-hmm. There's major shows. I'm not quite done yet. But the biggest news of all, I think, is number one, Cody lost. And number mm-hmm. two, I think the biggest story maybe in 20 years, not only has Endeavor basically purchased the WWE, mm-hmm. they've created a new company that is the WWE and UFC combined. Dana White is president of the UFC. Nick Khan is president of the WWE. Ari Emanuel's over everything. And Vince McMahon is above Dana White and basically has major control over the UFC now. Vince has won like nobody's ever won. And yeah. the only man above him, Ari Emanuel, manipulated multiple television networks into completely ignoring Dana White, slapping the taste out of his wife's mouth
yep.
in public. Vince is, Vince is basically Darth Vader before Return of the Jedi. It's like they just rolled the credits.
Yes, he is ascendant with the sleazy mustache and everything. Like, he knows it, too. Yeah.
Voldemort at the end of the Half-Blood Prince. I know he thinks he looks like Clark Gable right now.
Yeah.
He looks like something out of a Stephen King novel is what he looks like. It's
he
wild,
looks like
man.
Gomez Adams left out in the sun.
He went from being
completely done, leaving
in disgrace.
Yes, leaving in disgrace to now
King of the World.
Yeah. Insane.
King of the World.
Insane.
Settled all his lawsuits. He's got all this new money to pay off more hush money with mm-hmm. more women. He's living the life, man.
I was looking around for news reports on it, and a commenter named Benjamin, no last name, had a quote that I thought was pretty good. It said, "So Endeavor, the UFC, and WWE merged to form the most unsafe work environment for women in all sports."
Yes, absolutely.
It's like 100%. A mega monolith of objectifying and abusing women.
Yeah. Yeah. You've got to feel so bad for, say, the newer women in NXT who came in and they heard all these horror stories and they were sat down by Hunter and by Steph and told, like, he's gone. He's not coming back.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's a whole new world.
Yeah.
They're singing Little Mermaid songs. It's awesome.
Right.
And now he's back. His hair's dyed. He's taken, super beta prostate. He's just ready to roll, man.
Super beta prostate.
He's ready to roll. You can get that at Infowars.com.
That sounds like a name of a wrestler of a show you're about to tell me about later. Super Beta Prostate.
I saw some matches this weekend where Super Beta Prostate no one would blink an eye if Super Male Prostate entered the ring. No one would have batted an eye. And that tag team is from DDT, and they're called the Pheromones. I don't know their names. They had two matches. I watched one. It was hilarious. I attempted to watch the other, and I couldn't handle it. And my friend, I can handle almost anything, and I couldn't handle that second match. Yeah. But that's going to be a fun one to talk about.
Yeah.
So the one thing I really do hope comes out of this, honest to God, mm-hmm. not joking, is I hope Crazy Vince is like, listen, Dana, I don't care what the hell you think. We need to get some pomp and circumstance going.
Yeah.
In the UFC, we need fireworks. We need lasers. We need a ramp. That is what I would like to see come to the UFC. Just some simple things that would make it feel like big events when it's a big event.
Yeah. Just in terms of how these two companies are going to be affected, I could see it being WWE's not going to be that much different. It's going to, it's at least not presentationally, but But I could see a big difference coming in UFC before too long.
This is great for people like Brock and Ronda who might want to jump back and forth potentially for some big money fights. I think Conor McGregor is going to go ape shit in the playing around in WWE. I guarantee you, listen, we saw Floyd Mayweather knock out Big Show. I think we're 100% going to see Conor McGregor knock out Omos or Braun, one of those two, 100%. I think Vince is salivating at that idea.
Yeah.
Those will be fun things. Those will be really fun things. There's a lot they can do to work together in instances like that for big shows. But yeah, I think WWE is largely going to be unchanged. But there's a lot of things they could do for the UFC that would make it feel like a bigger sporting event. I think right now, if I'm Ari Emanuel, and I'm about to talk about something that literally no one has mentioned in any podcast, any interview I've seen. But it's going to come after this. If I'm Ari Emanuel right now, I either grab a boxing company or I start one. So either start it with Tyson Fury, start it with the Paul brothers. It doesn't matter. But you can become the – this is already the number one company in the history of combat sports.
Yeah.
Grab a boxing company and go for it. Now, what I wanted to talk about is after Endeavor bought the UFC the first time around, for a few years, everybody was – they were losing their minds. They had too much debt. They paid too much. But when the pandemic hit, Endeavor was in trouble. They're mainly a talent agency at that point. Their talent wasn't working. No one was working. They own, I think, a Pro Bull Riders Association. Nobody was bull riding. The UFC never stopped. And the UFC saved that company's existence. And there's only one other thing that didn't stop besides MMA. That was pro wrestling.
Yep.
They recognized that and they went out and grabbed it because they know no matter what happens, these two sports, which never stop, they have no off season. They're both going to go every single week. And I think that's brilliant. They got the only two things in sports which don't have off seasons, and COVID didn't even slow them down. That's brilliant buy. Brilliant buy.
It's just now kind of even sinking in what's actually happening. It's mind boggling.
Yeah.
How like the power play that just happened. It's crazy.
And it's bad. As bad as Vince is and as bad as Dana is, they're both good at run. Well, Dana is good at running his sport, but it's all those two together are still better than Saudi. Because I don't think Vince has had anybody murdered in a number of years. And I don't think Dana's probably had some people beat up.
Yeah.
But like Saudi's just murdering people all the time.
Yeah.
So I think overall it's better.
Yeah. Either way, Vince was growing that mustache and getting power back. So,
oh my God. I'm just ready to see him like swinging from ropes, from ships.
Yeah.
Like fighting pirates. My God, man.
With
That's the biggest thing to come out of WrestleMania, I believe.
Oh, easy. In fact,
we now have pictures of Vance McMahon himself. People have been begging for pictures for a while, and they finally got them,
and they weren't that far off from the fake
Vance
ones.
Vance is viral now. It's so good.
I've totally lost my thought now.
So I watched. I have to work, of course, on Patrol Live Friday and Saturday nights. That made it not smooth sailing on a lot of the shows I wanted to watch. I watched some of the first night of WrestleMania. For the first time in 9 years, I watched all of a WrestleMania on night two. And then all of that night.
I watched all of both.
It was a really good show, I thought. There was good wrestling on it. And I thought the main event was pretty great. There were some major problems I did have with it, even though it was a pretty great match. Until the last 30 seconds, and that was hot garbage, man. The last 30 seconds of that match, and I don't just mean that Cody lost.
Yeah.
I mean the fact that Cody hit him with two or three crossroads. He's holding
and the bionic elbow before that.
And the bionic elbow. He punched him.
Yep.
Did some punches. Then the bionic elbow. Then the crossroads. This man is effectively dead. His power meter is at zero.
Mm-hmm.
And then Solo Sikoa comes into the ring, stabs Cody in the throat, and I guess I missed the can of spinach they poured down Roman's throat, because all of a sudden he's at 100%,
yep.
Gets the spear, and Cody's done.
Yep.
All in a matter of seconds. Mm-hmm. There was no selling whatsoever for Cody's moves once Solo hit the ring.
Yeah, he should have been flat on his back.
Yeah, then 1, 2, 3, and the referee gets up. There's Solo Sikoa standing in the ring, a man he threw out of, not of the ring, out of the arena, ejected from the arena. No questions.
Nope.
Nothing. Just, it's all good. Yep. It's all good.
Fixes in.
Hated that. Hated it so much. Also, there was one, the problem I had during the match, there was one big problem. Let me tell you what grinds my gears, Kevin. And that's, both of these men are accomplished professional wrestlers.
Yes.
They know this is, for Cody, this is the biggest match of his career. And Cody repeatedly throughout the match would hit one move and go for the pin.
Mm-hmm.
Not follow up with another big move, just one move.
Mm-hmm.
And he would hit the crossroads or the Cody cutter and go in when that's not going to do it.
Right.
And Roman did largely the same thing throughout the match.
Mm-hmm.
Both guys were acting like they were rookies who'd never really had a big match before in their move selection. And I thought that was a little childish. It felt like it was a match for kids in that way, even though everything they did was good, as in all their moves were good. It was a good match. It was a well thought out match.
Mm-hmm.
Other than the move selection, the follow ups left a lot to be desired.
Yeah.
It kind of asked you to suspend your disbelief.
A little bit. The energy was good. I think the energy carried it. Like, it was at that point.
Yeah.
I was all in the bag.
And then when
WWE at that point.
When the referee is out and Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn come in.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, this has to happen. This is the night.
He gives Roman the Huluva kick. Like, it's poetic. They did.
Yeah.
It's like they sat down and they said, what is the perfect match for Cody to win? And then how can he lose?
Yep. And I wonder if this is the match they had laid out and Cody was going to win. And Vince comes back and he's like, no, he's not going to, like, he's too fat. God damn it. And somebody's like, he's not fat at all. He's got fat in his blood. God damn it. I'm like, God damn, Vince, Jesus. And it's just like, that's what I see happening.
You're going to let a turncoat come back here? And
he sees polka dots. He sees obese polka dots every time he looks at Cody, and that's not okay to win.
I mean, the reports are that at least some people are reporting that Roman was always planned to win the whole time. And if you put it in the context of, like, the year, that kind of makes sense, because the opponent was originally going to be The Rock. Right. And The Rock's not beating Roman Reigns. No. So the plan for Roman was to come out of WrestleMania as the champion. And so it stands to reason that when they put Cody in.
And I believe Paul and Jeff said, or one of them mentioned, that with the way Triple H books, faces never win the first
time. Yeah, that was Paul. Yeah. Yeah, right. Faces never win on the first try.
And Paul 100% knows more about WWE and its booking than I do.
Yeah. Easily. Yeah, and that makes sense. But it still sucked.
Still sucked. And no one is happy. No one is happy at all. And then I realized, oh, that's what it means to be a WWE fan.
Yeah.
Is unhappiness, pure unhappiness.
Yeah. I feel like I woke up this morning and I had, it was like, I was like, honey, I had the wildest dream. I dreamed that Vince McMahon was gone and Paul Levesque was running WWE, and it was awesome. And Kevin Steen and El Generico main evented WrestleMania and won the tag titles.
Yeah.
And Rhea Ripley had an awesome match and won and then all this happened, and then someone said, oh, that's funny, but that was just a dream. WrestleMania is tonight.
If we were starting two wrestling companies, and we it was a draft, and it was me and you going back and forth, which might be a really fun extra show, and everybody's available.
Mm-hmm.
Rhea Ripley's top five for me.
Oh, I say so too. Yeah,
maybe even top three. She is the woman I would build. Yeah. I'd build it all around. I would build a women's division around.
Easy.
I mean, her and Asuka, just those two. Those two. Yeah. My God.
Yeah. And Bianca, I want one of the main events next year to be Bianca versus Rhea.
Yeah,
I think it'd be great.
That's a hoss fight.
That is a hoss fight.
Yeah, and many people might be tuning in saying, "What about AEW?
What about AEW? How does this affect AEW?" I have one thought about it.
Great question. The Cody loss.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder. The thing is, he's there. He was in the main event. He is a huge star. That's one thing.
Yeah.
AEW people now know they can go there and be a huge star.
Mm-hmm.
But the rug being pulled out from under Cody feels so familiar.
Mm-hmm.
It's old school WWE where they always build somebody up. You're excited for them and they always pull the rug out from under them.
Yeah.
And that might have given a few people. A few former WWE people, a little bit of PTSD, might have had some flashbacks. They might have had some rough dreams themselves.
Might have.
After that, it was really cool seeing -1 at WrestleMania. His first I did like that. Hopefully of many. Cody gave him his belt, of course.
Yep.
As he was walking out to the ring, that was cool. We saw Brandy for the first time in a long time. And there's a lot of big AEW stuff going on. Tony Khan has a major announcement, which if I'm Tony Khan, I now say, you know what? Let's hold off that major announcement for another for a week.
Whatever it is, it ain't measuring up, man.
It doesn't matter what it is. He might have come up with a formula to bring Bruno Sammartino back from the dead live in the ring and
not
no
good
one's
enough.
Gonna care.
Nope.
No one.
Nope. That reminds me of my first thought of how this relates to AEW, which is this whole thing this weekend just convinces me that AEW needs to not be worried about WWE. Like,
yeah, they need to
do not try to be competing with this behemoth. They will crush you.
Here's the thing. I got into AEW because I got into indie wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
And I was following the Young Bucks and Cody and all these guys. And AEW gives me what I like out of indie wrestling.
Yeah.
And again, I like WWE weekend, Mania weekend, not for WrestleMania. And, and no one understands that. I try and tell them.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care about WrestleMania. I care about WrestleMania weekend because every wrestling organization in the world is there and having matches. And I want to see those. I want to see the bullshit matches. Give me your Outlaw Mud shows. That's what I'm here for. I'm an Outlaw Mud show guy. I'm a barbed wire guy, okay, from way back. And AEW for a long time has been the best of all those worlds.
Uh-huh.
And I would like for it to keep me in the best of all those worlds and not try and just be WCW. And WCW is just trying to be WWE, you know?
Yeah.
If you try and be WWE, you're just going to be WCW. Mm-hmm. And we've seen a little bit of that lately, and I don't want to see WCW out of AEW. And to anyone who's not intimately acquainted with pro wrestling, I just confuse the living shit out of you with all those letters.